Taylor Swift's dark plot to rig the 2024 election has entered its most sinister phase yet when she posted this on Instagram. You can see there on her story, today, March 5th is the presidential primary in Tennessee and 16 other states and territories. I wanted to remind you guys to vote the people who most represent you into power. If you haven't already, make a plan to vote today. Whether you're in Tennessee or somewhere else in the US, check your polling places and times at vote.org, which is a website. And that message of hatred and authoritarianism went out to her nearly 282 million followers. And the message could not be clearer. I know you saw it. Vote for Biden and the deep state. I mean, arguably the message, I guess, could be a little bit clearer if she'd mentioned Biden or the Democrats or Trump or the Republicans or literally any candidate or party, if she'd done literally anything other than just encourage people to vote for whoever represents them, which could be a Democrat or could be a Republican. You could have some Taylor Swift loving conservative who's gonna go out to vote for some reprehensible Republican who wants to take away her rights, but she would have been encouraged to do that by what Taylor Swift said. Before we continue with the story, we depend on members to keep on going. Don't wait, click join now on YouTube. And honestly, while I have no doubt that right wingers on Fox News, even as I'm saying this, are freaking out about Taylor Swift once again trying to get people to vote, is what she said there that different from what Donald Trump bleated earlier today, which is Super Tuesday, a really big deal. Please get out and vote. Dear God, the conspiracy has spread to Trump himself. Just trying to get people to participate in the election. But look, obviously, conspiracy theories and jokes aside, in the past, when she's tried to get people to vote, she's been very successful at doing that. And if she were to endorse a candidate, which she of course is not, that would be a big deal. I mean, 6% of respondents in a recent survey said that calling on her fans to participate in the election would change their likelihood of voting. And 1 in 20 have said that if she endorsed a candidate, that would force them to consider changing their vote, which I know Fox would be scared of. I personally think that if only 1 in 20, 5%, would consider changing their vote, I would say that's not a very persuasive influence. At best, she's getting people to participate in the election, not to vote for a particular candidate. But anyway, if you saw her call to vote and you heeded it, you might be facing a different legal situation in terms of voting than you might recall, because 8 states have enacted voter ID laws just since the 2020 election, and you're seeing which states there. In fact, why don't we bring up a map where you can see the current status of voter ID laws, which is changing fast. 1 in 6 voters live in anticipated 2024 battleground states that have new ID requirements. And a lot of people living in those states will not understand exactly what those requirements are. They're different from state to state. They're very confusing. And a case could be made that that is kind of the point, that the point of this is to stop people from voting, but not everybody from voting, certainly not everybody at the same rates, because as I'm sure you know, survey participants asked about voter ID who are identified as Black or Hispanic were twice as likely as other groups to lack photo IDs. And in particular, 18 to 29 year olds in those demographics were the least likely to have driver's licenses or any photo ID out of all of those groups. So racially, if you throw up voter ID laws, it is not going to affect every group equally. And clearly Republicans have made the calculus that they will come out of this situation doing better than the other side. But I will also remind you that while we often focus on the fact that there is a racial component to this, it isn't just a racial thing. Transgender people living in states with voter ID laws, like more than a quarter million are unlikely to have a voter ID that will qualify under the law and can face a lot of harassment when they try to vote with the ID that they actually have. All told, about 1 in 5 registered voters did not know when they were going to be asked to show voter ID back in 2016. And those numbers are almost certainly gonna be higher now because it's been passed in a lot of states since then. This is going to create chaos. This is definitely going to disenfranchise voters. The thing is, we don't know how many, we don't know who, and by design, we likely never will. So if you wanna vote, if you wanna give Taylor Swift what she wants, which is you participating in the political system, do your research, make sure that you have the right documentation so that your vote will actually be counted.